This is for those of you that have multiple electronic accessories, whether they be lights, lockers, compressors, whatever else you need a switch for, and are looking for a switch that's going to be in a very easy to reach location. And this particular panel that comes with the switches is going to come with lighted switches that let you know where they are and when they're on. So it is a very complete setup. Today we're going to talk through the installation of this switch panel, which I am going to give a 2 out of 3 wrenches. There is going to be some cutting involved in order to get this installed. If you're not interested in doing that type of cutting, there are some other brands out there that completely replace the 8-pillar trim panel, so you don't have to drill or cut into it. However, if you like this design and you're willing to do a little bit of cutting, then this is going to be a pretty good choice for you. But again, 2 out of 3 wrenches probably take you around an hour to get this installed, or some of those other versions are just going to clip right into place, but we'll talk more about the install in just a second. Now, the benefit to a piece like this that does require some drilling and cutting is that you're going to be able to get this to fit very, very well. One of the complaints with the versions that replace the entire 8-pillar trim piece is that they don't always stay exactly where you want them. They don't fit the best sometimes. This one is going to fit very, very well, and it does have a little bit more of a rugged, utilitarian, almost fighter pilot feel on the inside of the Jeep. When you have this cut in, recessed in, you have the exposed rivet pieces that are holding it into place. So it definitely is a different feel, maybe a little bit less fit and finish than the pieces that completely replace the A-pillar. But again, it is going to fit very well. So you have a couple of different choices when you're looking at an 8-pillar switch panel, and this one definitely has its benefits. If you're considering pricing, this one versus the other ones that do also come with the switches, they're gonna be right around the same price. So it really comes down to the style you like and how easy of an install you're looking for. From a construction standpoint, you're going to have a plastic piece that holds the switches in place, and that's going to be very, very similar to that interior trim piece that's factory on your Jeep. So it's gonna match very, very well. Of course, you're going to have 4 switches. They are going to be lighted switches, so you're going to be able to see the switches very easily, tell when they're on and off, and there are a couple different ways that you can wire those switches up. And the most important thing about the way this is constructed is something we already talked about. This requires a lot of cutting of that factory trim piece. It's going to kind of sit on the outside of that trim piece, but you do have to cut out a large area in the back to be able to get all of your wires in there. So that's really what sets this apart from some of those snap-in pieces that you can get from Rugged Ridge, for example. So to get this installed, again, a 2 out of 3 wrench installation, about an hour's time. The first step is going to be removing your sun visor in order to remove a small piece of trim and get your full 8-pillar trim piece out of the Jeep. Once it's completely out of the Jeep, this does come with a template. So you'll wrap the template around the trim piece, tape it, make sure it's not gonna move, make sure you have it in the right spot, and then drill in all of the spots that they tell you to. There are going to be 4 holes around the outside that are going to be used for the plastic rivets that hold everything in place, and then 4 starter holes in the larger rectangle that you need to cut out. Then you'll cut out that rectangle either using a very sharp utility knife or a Dremel type tool, whatever you decide. If you drill those starter holes large enough, you could even use a hacksaw blade in there. However you decide to cut it out is up to you. And you do have a little bit of play here, a little bit of trim, so if that cut isn't perfect, you are gonna be able to cover that up, which is a nice feature. After that, you're gonna wanna pull your switch wires up into place while everything's still apart. Pull your switch wires up into the corner of the dash. Then you can go ahead and bolt this to your 8-pillar trim piece, attach all of your wiring together, put your 8-pillar trim piece back in place, then snap that upper trim in place, and finally reinstall your sun visor. So again, a little bit of an involved install. There's definitely some cutting. This is not going to be easily reversed. It will probably take you around an hour to complete it, but when you're done, you are going to end up with a very well-fitting set of switches. This switch panel with all 4 switches will run you right around $70, and that is the going rate for a switch panel with the switches included. Now, you can get some other versions, again, that just snap in place, don't require cutting. You can get those with or without switches. So there's gonna be a little bit of a variety there, but for a panel that includes the switches, this is a fair price. So whether you would rather spend your $70 on this version or on a version that doesn't require cutting is completely up to you, how you like your installs to go and what you want your Jeep to look like. So that's my review of the Daystar 8-pillar switch panel, including 4 switches fitting your 2007 and up JK, that you can find right here at extremeterrain.com.